I was drawn to the PhD Innovation Program because it is sort of the only program of its kind where you can do all of the workload of a normal PhD and do the research and the academic work, but then also get this bird's eye view, this bigger picture view of how your work is translating and relating to the real world, and that's through additional coursework and interacting with other students with the same interests.
My PhD broadly looks at how can we develop more effective disease diagnostics for infectious disease, and that could be for global health settings or also centralized laboratories.
Medical problems are huge, so the idea of building better diagnostics to help patients get the right treatment was really motivating. And we have all the tools to do that here with the resources at Dartmouth-Hitchcock and at Tuck and at Thayer. My days sort of split between lab work, bench work, analysis, and writing. There was a lot of coursework, and now it's transitioned to almost full-time designing experiments, writing papers, working with other students, doing grant updates, and then applying to competitions and other things to sort of get funding to translate this work out of the lab.
So by translation, I mean actually taking a technology from the lab bench to the market. So a lot of the times we see in academia publications of scientific knowledge, but it just sits in a publication and it's not actually utilized in the community and in the larger scheme of the world.
We're trying to solve the problem of bloodstream infection. Right now, the method of diagnosing a patient who has a bloodstream infection and determining the right antibiotic is really long and it involves a lot of separate steps in the hospital. And we're trying to make sort of a compact, small technology that can do this much, much more quickly by capturing the pathogen that's causing the infection and then determining what the right treatment might be.
What's really critical is that in the context of bloodstream infections, patient mortality increases by about 7.6% at every hour is delayed. That makes time to diagnosis an extremely critical variable in predicting patient outcomes. There's a growing problem of antibiotic resistance, and so that requires clinicians be very careful in their administration of antibiotic therapy. So our diagnostic tool allows them to target antibiotic therapy much more quickly than current diagnostic workflows allow for.
One of the major things that we've been doing in conjunction with the lab research is talking to a lot of people who might be using this product one day. So we're participating in the Site iCor grant, which allows us to sort of get into doctors' offices, speak to patients, insurance companies, hospitals, figure out what it takes to actually get a product on the shelves and being used by clinicians and what would be most useful to them as we're in the process of developing it.
I think a lot of times in engineering and academia, right, we invent something really cool and then we're trying to find a market for it. What we've done is we've said, there's a clear need for this and let's engineer for that need. And so I think right from the get-go, we kind of framed our mindset towards that, and I think the PhD Innovation Program helped frame our mindset in that way. Instead of, oh, we developed this cool widget, let's figure out where it fits, we're saying, no, this is a huge global problem and let's use our scientific and engineering core skills to solve that problem.